Greetings, this is Brad from the Cheese Shop. So on this video about creating a GURPS character, I'm going to talk about disadvantages. And much like advantages, there is one of the main similarities between both of them, is that there are still the three categories of disadvantages. The first one is mental, second one is physical, and the third one is social. And those are also subcategorized into the same exotic, supernatural, and mundane. So when you're looking at the character sheet, just look to the right of the actual disadvantage and it'll tell you exactly what kind of character a disadvantage it is. One of the things about disadvantages that is that you need to know about is the self-control of the disadvantage. So whenever you take a disadvantage, a great example would be kleptomania. Now obviously a disadvantage because it can get you in a ton of trouble. It's going to come with some sort of level. And whenever I say like a self-control level, I mean when you roll your 3 6-sided dice for a check, let's say that you would steal only if you rolled a 9 or less. So kleptomania would be worth so many points based on that different self-control level. Now, out of all the years that I've played GURPS, one of the things that I try to do is because I think disadvantages round out your character. What I usually do is I just try to play without a self-control role. I sit there and I take stock in how I've been playing for the session or throughout the campaign, and I say, you know what, if I took kleptomania, I would try to steal something at some point within the adventure. And sometimes I would do it at a really inopportune time. Like, you know, we're giving a statement to the police, and then I decide, well, hey, I'm going to try to steal the cop's badge. Obviously, that's going to come with a lot more consequences, but it actually adds more to the story. So instead of saying, you know, well, I'm a kleptomaniac and I steal, you know, sometimes, and I'm just going to steal, you know, some, you know, like a pack of gum, you know, while we're buying something at the store or whatever, that doesn't sound like a lot of fun. So whenever I play these disadvantages, I tend not to go with any type of self-control roles. I just do the disadvantage. You're playing a character, so you're just trying to get the most out of the character, and I think that that's one of the best ways to do that. So whenever you buy these disadvantages, just be aware that you read through the descriptions of the disadvantage, because it is important to know exactly what you're signing up for. Because a lot of people, when they first start making GURPS characters, they see, you know, some of these disadvantages are worth a lot of points, and of course you get these points back because they're negative numbers for the point buy system. So what winds up happening is players will tend to take always the same 3 or 4 disadvantages that they think they can just get away with and, you know, not actually play within the adventure just to get the points back, to raise their dexterity or to get a few more skills or to buy a really cool advantage. So there's a lot of, you can kind of min-max a little bit. So the self-control is actually part of the game mechanics to prevent that from actually happening whenever players actually take those disadvantages. So it gives the GM an opportunity to say, hey, look, you know, you haven't stolen anything. We've played 5 sessions already. You know, you need to start rolling, and you need to start rolling now. So this kind of gives the GM a tool to actually enforce the disadvantage. And it also gives for players that don't necessarily role play very often or role play very well, maybe it gives them an opportunity to actually say, okay, now I've got to actually role play this disadvantage. Now, in disadvantages, in the section, there's a little section called quirks. Now, quirks in GURPS actually work. They're really cool. They're actually -1 point. You can have up to 5 of them in your with your character. And the cool thing about quirks is there something, it's not a passive disadvantage. Something like I only wear blue, that is not a quirk. So for me, I think actually a quirk would be something like a player that's chauvinistic. Now it's going to give a negative to any kind of interaction that you have with someone. So if, you know, if I go with a party to buy something at the shop, you know, some armor or sword or something like that, and the person working behind the counter is a female, and I'm completely chauvinistic, obviously I'm going to have some negative, there's going to be some negative feelings there. And, you know, as you start role playing that out, you're going to not necessarily get a very good deal. You're going to be paying full price for something. So there is something negative associated with a quirk, but it's not something so major that it's a greater hindrance that would be considered a disadvantage. Because if that's the case, so if you're chauvinistic to the point to where it's just beyond something that's like just a little quirk, then it becomes a disadvantage. So you'll start seeing the interesting thing about quirks is how players tend to pick them and what they actually select. It's really cool to see, because there's not very many role-playing games that actually have something like quirks. So it's really neat to see different players that have played other systems or new players find out, you know, to come up with five different things that just kind of make their character a little different. And I think it brings some reality to the player character. It just makes it a little bit more, it just makes it more real. And in turn, it rounds out the player character. This is to the point to where, you know, you're almost done with making your character. If you started from the beginning, you know, you just have skills left and, you know, then buying things. So now you're at the point to where your character is really starting to take shape. And I think quirks is something that just rounds out your PC very well. So as always with all these other videos, and I always stress this every single time, not going to stop, you got to talk to your GM about what expectations need to be set for disadvantages. Very much important is the limits the GM sets. And not necessarily the limits between the different categories of disadvantages, things you can and can't have, but also the points that you're allowed to take so it doesn't completely unbalance the game. So, you know, I've seen typically it's minus 40 points are the most that you can have as far as disadvantages go, plus or minus. You know, that I, as a GM, I've never counted quirks into that, and I've also never counted attributes or appearance or anything like that. I've always just given minus 40 points worth of disadvantages, and I mean disadvantages in the actual disadvantage section. So, you know, someone can take minus 40 points in disadvantages, but also take, you know, very, very ugly as far as, you know, something in appearance, which is also a negative. So, and just add to that. But every GM is different, so just kind of go with that. And just because it's mine, you know, there is a limit on disadvantages, doesn't mean you have to take them. I've actually played characters that didn't have any disadvantages, and I just made them. They just had quirks. I used that to round out the character, and actually, you know, I just made them a little bit more, I guess, normal in some respects. So just kind of keep that in mind, is you don't have to take all the disadvantages. And then also when you take a disadvantage, I think an important thing to remember, I think I've said this before, is it to read through it and make sure you understand it and how you're going to incorporate it into the game. I mean, because after all, it is a role-playing game. And I know some people don't necessarily like to role-play as much. They really like the, you know, the combat kind of hack and slash, and, you know, let's kill monsters and gather treasure. But if you kind of think of it past that, like, why are you doing that? You can really start to get your disadvantages. And you can kind of see, well, the reason I like to hack and slash is because I'm bloodthirsty. Well, that's a disadvantage. So you can see how, even if all you really focus on is combat, that can actually, there's some of those disadvantages that you can take that can make that a little difficult. So, and you'd be role-playing, even though you not necessarily know that you're role-playing, because you're just playing the character how you think it should be played. So just kind of keep an eye out for that. And if this is the first time you've ever making a GURPS character and you're going to be playing it, you know, don't be afraid to take something that you don't necessarily know exactly how to role play. You know, ask the GM, say, hey, you know, I'm like bloodthirsty. I'm taking this disadvantage, you know. What would you like to see me do? And just kind of get some ideas. Not saying you have to do it completely exactly. You can just, you know, just do what you can. So the disadvantages are something that are really important to the character, I think, in the concept. And I mean, I know I did say there's a few times that I actually didn't take any disadvantages, but I also count quirks into that. So just make sure that when you're taking your, you're making your character, that you're thinking about the disadvantages you're taking, and that you're taking them for the right reasons in your character concept. So that's going to be it for disadvantages. Like I said, they're pretty much like advantages with just a few exceptions. And also, you get points back. So this is going to be the one of the few times where you're going to get some points back to spend on your character. So choose these disadvantages wisely. And if you haven't been to my blog before, it's thecheeseshop.org, and which is down the link down here at the bottom. And I'm going to see you guys in the next video. All right? Bye.